everything that you have lost from the time past, you will recover them in this world.
As a place of refuge. When Saul was after him, Saul was after David to kill him so that David would not enter the throne. And David migrated to Ziklag, and his men and his wife and his children, and they stayed there. One day, David and his men then went out, and when they came back, the Bible made us understand that an enemy they came. Who are the enemy? The Philistines. They came and they burned all the places. They took David's wife, they took everything, all their belongings, and they took it back to the land. This thing is happening in the place of Ziklag. And when David came and his men, and he saw that everywhere was burned with fire, even his wife was taken away. And everything, they destroyed all the things and took out all their belongings and their property away. And David wept. Say he wept.
He wept.
I don't know who is weeping here. Say he wept. Say he cried. I don't know who is crying here. David cried. He wept unto God. And the Bible said that he inquired from the Lord. Should I pursue them? And if I pursue them, should I overtake them? Say, I will overtake my enemy today. Say, I will pursue to recover today. Say, I will pursue to recover today. Say, I will pursue to recover today. Someone here, you will pursue and recover today. Now, listen to me. There are things I want you to know in this message. If you understand the story very, very well, there are things I want you to understand. Now, this is the month of April, the fourth month of the year. And it's the first month for the second quarter of the year. Hallelujah. Now, this month of April is signified the month after Jesus' resurrection. It means we enter into a new life. Hallelujah. The Bible says, all things have passed away. Behold, all things become new. Now, those who are sorrow before, those who face difficulties, and those who encounter one thing or the other, I want you to forget the past. Because here is newness of life. Everything will turn to new. Hallelujah. Everything around you, they will all turn to new. So the old is gone. That is the resurrection. We are still in the month of resurrection. Hallelujah. And the Bible says, made us understand that after Jesus resurrected, we died with him, buried with him, and we resurrected with him. Remember that Jesus left the linen cloth in the tomb. Those linen cloth means all your suffering has been already left in the tomb. All your disappointment, all your failure, your sickness, every area of your life that is not going well, you have already left them in the tomb. Hallelujah. And after Jesus resurrected, everyone in the world begin to experience newness of their life. Your sins, your chains all are broken. Your sins are all forgiven. Every yoke in your life, they are all broken. You begin to experience freedom in your life. That is the newness of life. So someone here, you are going to experience newness of life in this world. I say you experience newness of life. I say you experience newness of life. In your business, newness of life. In your marriage, newness of life. In the name of Jesus. Now listen to me carefully. There are things I want you to know in order to recover. Because when they say pursue to recover, it has to take some principle. It has to take some things that will enable you to pursue in order to recover.
Hallelujah.
Now, number one point I want you to understand, before you must recover, you will first of all discover what is your problem.
What is your
problem?
You cannot say you want to recover whereas you have never discovered what you have lost. What have you lost? You need to discover your problem. You need to discover what you are going through. You need to discover those things that you lost. In other words, you may not be able to recover anything without knowing what you have lost. If I may ask you, what have you lost in your life? What is missing in your life? What can you identify as one of the things that is lost in your life? It's missing. Enemies have taken it. Or you yourself mistakenly have lost it. You must discover what you have lost. You must discover your problem before you are able to pursue. David discovered that the sickle was burnt with fire. He discovered that the wife was taken away by the enemy. He discovered that all his property and his belonging was taken by the enemy. Have you discovered anything in your life that is missing? What is in your life right now that you know that have lost this? Touch your neighbor, say discover.
Discover.
Say discover your problem.
Discover.
Say discover your problem.
Discover.
Say discover what you have lost.
Discover what you have lost.
In the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 17, he said, anyone who belongs to Christ has become a new person. Behold, all life has gone. Hallelujah. Now, it doesn't matter whatever you have lost. It doesn't matter whatever that is missing in your life. As long as you discover it, that is all. Now, new life has come. It means that restoration has come. Hallelujah. You will be restored. Life has passed away. What you have gone through in the time past, you need to forget them. You need to let them go. Because anything you went through in life is an experience. Whatever you go through in life is for you to have an experience. And through experience, you gain knowledge.
Hallelujah.
You are being aware of it, that this mistake will not occur again. It's because of this that made me fail before. I will never fail in this path anymore again. So let me tell you, people have already limited themselves because of certain mistakes or because of circumstances. Let me tell you, the Bible made us understand clearly that we are not a failure. It is only our mentor that fails. No one God caused to fail. You cannot say, I am not a failure. You cannot fail. It's only mentor that failed. You do business and fail. You are not the one that failed. It is the mentor that failed. You married and the marriage failed. Not you failed. It is the marriage that that failed. So you are not to stop intimidating yourself. Stop letting yourself down. Stop giving yourself a cause. God did not cause you. He said, my thought for you is not a thought of evil, but a thought of what? A thought of good. The thought of God for you is a thought of good. It's not a thought of evil. So why are you humiliating yourself? Why are you humiliating yourself? Most of people, what you are going through is not as a result of anyone. It's as a result of yourself. Today I preached in Bujumbura. I told them, learn how to make a decision. Many people, their life is in the hands of another person. It's another person that made decision for them. If people are eating mango, you will see them eating mango. Their life is just to emulate others. Every test destiny has a destination. And your destination is not my destination. The route that led to my destination can never be the same route that led to your own destination. If you imitate me, if you follow my destination, you follow my route, you will end up missing road. Because my destination, I know the route to my destination.
You cannot emulate one another. Don't them learn how to make a set decision. There's Holy Spirit. The Bible made us understand that Holy Spirit is there to guide us, to lead us, to show us, even to tell us what to do. If you don't know what to do, if you don't know how to make a decision, pray and ask Holy Spirit. He will guide you and He will lead you. And He can never lead you to the wrong path. He will always lead you to the right path. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Then number two, if you must recover, you must know that only God gives the power to recover. Only God gives the power to recover. You must trust God. Anything you go through in life, first of all, trust God. Look upon God. The Bible said in the book of Proverbs that those who put trust in men shall be disappointed. But those who put trust in God, their strength shall be renewed. So many people here, you trust human being even more than God. I trust him so much, why he did this to me. Human being failed, but God never failed. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
What is trust? Having confidence on something. How can you have confidence on mortal men? If men, people that even live, even their heart can change at any time. This body you see, so it can change at any time. Heart of men can change at any time. You will see somebody, he has a good heart, he has a servant heart, and he is very obedient, but within a short time, you can change. That is human being. That is why you should not trust human being, trust God. When you trust God, God can command human being to give you what you expected. You see, when you trust God, God can send a helper in form of human being. When you trust God, God can make way through human being. But when you trust men, men will disappoint you. Women that trusted men, you trust men, men will disappoint you. Even those who are married, those who have fiancé, trust God in your marriage. Trust God in your relationship. Trust God in you doing boyfriend and girlfriend. Trust God. When you trust God, God will always perfect your wife. When you trust God, God will always perfect your husband. That is it. Hallelujah. Don't just carry your heart and give to man or give to woman. At the end of the day, your heart will be broken. Man can break your heart, but God will never break your heart. Women can break your heart, but God will never do what? God will never break your heart. Are you blessed with the message?
Yes, sir.
Only God is the one you need to trust. Isaiah 14, verse 31. He said, "For those who trust in him, their strength shall be what?
Renewed.
Their strength shall be renewed." The more you trust God, the more you wake up, the more you rise up, the more you have confidence, the more you live, and the more you are favored. Then number three, if you must recover, you must inquire of the Lord. The Bible says, after David discovered that the Ziklag has burnt with fire, the wife had been taken away, all his belongings, David, he consulted or he inquired of the Lord. There are many people here, when you have problems, you are passing through a circumstance. Instead of you to inquire of God, you begin to inquire from them. You begin to ask people. And the people you are asking, God is not in there. There is a devil, evil spirit in
death. When you inquire of evil spirits, you make inquiry from the evil spirit will lead you to the evil way. There are people here, you have problems, you have issues, instead of you to go and ask God, or ask your pastor, because your pastor is the person representing God in your life. Ask your pastor, or you pray locked door and pray unto God. Ask him. God has every answer. He is your maker. Every question that is created by God has an answer. David inquired of the Lord, should I pursue? The Lord said, pursue. Should I overtake? The Lord said, yes, you will overtake. And David do what? He pursued. There are many people here, your friend has led you to the wrong path. Wrong counsel. That is why your life is in the wrong way. There are decisions, even your parents cannot make decision for you. Even your own mother, your own father cannot make decision for you. Because if your parents, they don't have God in them. Their parents, they don't have the Holy Spirit of God, and God is not in them. They believe in other things. And what they believe, they will give you counsel based on what they believe. If you are a believer, your parents are not believers, how your parents will counsel you in a godly way? Is it possible? Is it possible for your parents to counsel you in a godly way when they are not godly? The Bible says that the counsel of men will never stand. That the counsel of God will always what? Always stand. Rely on God's counsel. Mind who you ask questions about your life. Mind who you inquire for anything. Mind who counsel you. Mind who give you advice. Because people can give you advice that will destroy your destiny. Now, Satan attack you. You are looking for advice. You go and seek advice from somebody who has Satan. Satan will succeed giving you an advice that will make him to capture you very, very well. That is true. You must be very careful who gives you advice. David did not inquire from anyone, but he inquired of the Lord. He seeks the face of God. He asked God, should I pursue? What should I do? Should I overtake? And the Lord spoke to him. Every question that you ask God in life has an answer. You have issue in your relationship? Inquire of the Lord. You have issue in your marriage? Inquire of the Lord. You have issue in your work, in your job? Inquire of the Lord. You have a spiritual issue, spiritual problem? Make inquiry. Inquire of the Lord. And God will give you answer. Say, my God will give me answer. Say, my God will give me answer. Then number four, you must pursue and recover. For you to pursue and recover, you must draw friends that does not make impact in your life. For you to pursue and recover, you must draw friends that does not make impact in your life. When you read that place, the Bible makes us understand that the message from that man with who? With David. But David dropped 200 men. When they reach a place they call Besor. Besor is a place that is cold. The people, those 200 people, they could not stand. They, you know, there are some friends in your life. They just only want to benefit from you. But they don't want to face the heat. They don't want to share. Even when you are in trouble, they don't want to share your trouble. They don't want to share your problem. They only want to eat when you are eating. Such friends, drop them. David dropped the 200 men.
Because when they get to Bethsaul,
they will relent in effort because they don't want to feel the heat. They don't want to follow David or confront those enemies.
David dropped them. You need to drop some friends in your life. Any friend that is not making impact in your life, drop them. The Bible says, whatever my father did not plant there shall be what? Shall be planted. There are many people, your friends, is limiting the glory of God upon your life. Association, the people you associate with. The people you move up with. Look around yourself. Look around your friends. You and them, which one is better? Are you self-same like them? People are in life where the bears of the same fellow fruit or better. Your friends. You have a friend that is adding into your life. You don't have a friend that is bringing changes into your life. You don't have friends that is putting more things into your life. Can you give a testimony? If not because of this brother, if not because of brother John, if not because of brother Emeka, my life wouldn't have been like this. If you are a person, you don't have such testimony around your friend, you need to drop those friends. Drop friends that are eaters and drinkers. Drop them. They are the one who walk at you at the back. You need to drop your bad friends. People who are close with you. Check them very, very well. Most of the people that fall in the Bible, it was through their friends, the people that are close with them, who betrayed Jesus, the Judah that betrayed him. Joseph, who sold Joseph and sent him to prison, is it not his brothers? Sometimes people who are close to you and people who are related to you, they are the cause of your downfall. You need to check well, check around yourself. There were 600 men that always go with David, but he dropped the 200. Why he dropped them? Because they are useless. There are friends that are useless in your life. There are friends, they are causing havoc in your destiny. There are friends, they are causing all kinds of trouble. They are limiting the glory of God upon your life. There are friends, they are giving you wrong counsel. There are friends, they are giving you things that will not make you to prosper. Forget about the open teeth in your presence. And the back, they will use needle to choke your body. Say, I will drop them. 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 You need to begin to drop those friends and see whether they will be changed in your life. If David keep looking upon them, if David keep trying them, you discover that they will not pursue and overtake. I tell the truth. They will not pursue and overtake. David drop them and keep pursuing. Say, I will drop them and keep pursuing. Yes. You need to begin to check around yourself. People do not understand the meaning of friendship. Not everyone you will call my friend. Somebody will say, Malaysia, here, anyway, where they say your friend. If I hear you from any Malaysian, I say, it's not my friend. Don't say my friend. Not everybody is your friend. God called Abraham, you are my friend. Who is a friend? A friend who is loyal to you. Who eat with you, who drink with you, who submit to you, who can listen to you. People don't know the meaning of friend. Not everyone you select to be your friend. You are somebody can chat, you are somebody can talk, you are somebody can open tea together, but you are not a friend. Forget about all these friend things. You talk with somebody or you visit that the person or whatever, that does not mean that he's your friend. You can visit a brother, you can visit a sister. But it's not your
friend.
You're not my friend. People don't know what it means to be a friend to somebody. Anybody that is your friend is ready to die with you. When you are feeling pain, your friend feeling pain. I see so many people say, this is my friend, this is my friend. When you don't even have someone telling you to buy credit, those people you call your friend, they will be laughing at you. They say, useless guy, get out of my face. At the end, they will come and say, it's mine. When your friend sees you, he knows that this, my friend, is going through something. Without even opening mouth, telling him. That is a good friend. A friend who is ready, willing to sacrifice for you. He is loyal to you. He can even kneel down before you. You also can kneel down before him. When you see your friend, you see yourself. When he sees you, he sees himself. That is friend. Now select your friends. Say, I will select my friends. Say, I will select my friends. In the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verse 33, he said, bad friend will corrupt good manner. Be not deceived always. Evil association corrupt the good manner. Evil association corrupt good manner. Bad friend corrupt good manner. You are a good person. Most of you here, you are good. You are brought up with a good family background. Your character, everything in you is good. But you are being corrupted because of your friend. The kind of life you are living today is not because you choose to live like that. That was not the way your parents brought you up. Then because of your friend. There are many people here, you are smoking goof. Not because you were trained and born to smoke goof, but because of your friend. You are a drunkard. Not because your parents trained you how to drink and how to get drunk, but you are a drunkard today because of your friends. Bad friends corrupt a good manner. Number five. Are you there? Did not give any attention to him. He was frustrated there. And David asked him, can you lead us to the place where the raiders, those who raided and burned Ziklag, where they are, can you lead us to that place? The man said, yes.
They give him bread. They give him water to drink. They give him all kinds of things. And he took them to that place.
Number five says, if you must recover, don't despise anyone that is around you.
Sometimes when you are waiting upon the Lord, God may send a person that you may think that is a useless person. God may send a beggar on your way. God may send somebody begging out. You may think that this is a useless person, but you don't know that this is sent by who? By God.
David did not allow the mindset of enmity to cover his victory.
David paid attention to the man, despite that he was among those who raided the place.
So for you to recover, you must always pay attention. Always try to pay attention to those around you first.
Don't judge anyhow.
There are people here, because you are being hurt, because of your past, you concluded that I am not going to mingle with anyone. I am not going to share it with anyone.
And you don't know you are closing your door. Especially those men and women who have been in relationship, have been hurt before. I don't want to enter any relationship again.
And you don't know that there is someone that God has positioned for you. You don't know that there is a saint that God has arranged for you. Because of your self-doctrine, because of your self-conclusion, the glory denied.
There are people here, your past has covered the glory of the present.
What happened past is what you are bringing, and that has been a limitation, a hindrance to your present. The Bible says, all things has passed away. Behold, all things become new.
Don't let your past to cover your present.
Don't let your past to stand as an obstacle to your present. Because every present, every morning is always new. And there are new blessings that God always gives us every morning. When you wake up, new blessing. That's why you need to forget the past. You failed yesterday does not mean that tomorrow you will fail. There's another door that will open when another door closes. You cried yesterday. That's a season of crying. It does not mean that tomorrow you will cry. Tomorrow, the season of laughter will do what? Will come. You suffered yesterday. That does not mean that tomorrow you will suffer. Tomorrow, breakthrough will do what? Will come. Everything has season. This is the season of newness of life. I see somebody here. This is your season. I see this here. Prayer is your season. It's a season of launching into your new breakthrough. It's a season of new open doors. It's a season of new contact. I say it's my season. If it's your season, jump and say it's my season. Say it's my season. Say it's my season.
Don't despise anyone that comes around you. Don't limit anyone. That useless man that come your way might be a door that God has opened. Some of you, when you are waiting upon the Lord, when you are seeking something from God, God will send. God will not send people who are well-dressed. God will not send people who carry big chain on their head. God will always send people who will, even without nothing, and you will use the eye, the physical eye, don't look at them. You will say, this kind of person coming my way when I'm waiting for a miracle. No! Read your Bible very well. Do you remember when Jesus, he taught the disciples, he said, when I'm naked, you clothe me not. When I'm hungry, you give me food not. When I'm thirsty, you give me water not. The disciples said, when did we see you naked? We did not give you clothes. He told them, if you did not do it to the least among the world, you did not do it to me.
despising people, letting people down. There are people here, you intimidate others. You don't know that you are intimidating God. You are intimidating the angel. You are intimidating the opportunity that God has opened. You are intimidating the door that God has opened. You want to make sure that you intimidate everyone that's around you. Let me tell you, you are chasing away the breakthrough that God has opened for you. That is true. There are some people, even when you receive small door, you become a king over everyone that surrounded you. Even your friends, they are no longer your friends anymore. You are the one ruling. Remember, there is a season that money will be in your pocket. There's also a season that your pocket will be empty. Despising people, letting people around you down. Anyone that around you, embrace them, show them love. Even though they're not your friends, show them what? Love. We chase away every good thing that God has provision for us because we despise people. We limit and intimidate people. We try to let them know that we are powerful than them. I am greater than you. Do you know how many houses I have? Do you know how much I have in account? When did you come to Malaysia? I've been in Malaysia for almost 6 years. You went to Malaysia yesterday. You went to talk in my prison. Let me tell you, he who come to Malaysia yesterday can make it now. Yes. That is what always comes back from the bush. We are the foundation. We are the one who established it. We are the one. We are the maker of it. I read in my Bible, one king, he was, exalting himself. He was giving himself glory. And immediately the glory of God departed. The grace departed. Sometimes when you are proud, when you want to exalt yourself, when you want to claim that it's by your strength, it's by your power, the glory and the grace will do what? Will depart.
Amen.
And immediately glory and grace depart, the next thing you see is affliction. Those who pride are leading. It is time to kill pride. Kill the spirit of pride. Kill the spirit of
pride.
Don't intimidate others. Don't use your position. Don't use your weight. Don't use the glory of God upon your life. Don't use what God has given to you to intimidate others.
Yes.
If you use it to intimidate others, God will do all. God will take it from you and give it to those that need it. Don't use money to intimidate others. I've seen many people who fall from high, the highest high, to the down and the most down place. They fall and fall totally because of pride. They want to use the glory, the grace to intimidate others. Remember that you who have made it, another person can make it again. Not only you. Success is not made for only one person. Success is for everybody. It's turn by turn. If it comes to you today, tomorrow that shall be my turn. If it comes to you tomorrow, another day will be another person turn. Every day cannot be yours. Everyone has his own portion. Say, I have my own portion. Say, if it comes to you, if it comes to me. Don't think that only you have become. You cannot believe. Hallelujah. Now, number 6. What brings quick recovery is you must initiate fasting and prayer. Say fasting and prayer.
Fasting and prayer.
When David inquired of the Lord, He was not making inquiry from the Lord just only to ask. He was praying. Hallelujah. You must initiate fasting and then
prayer.
You must fast and pray in order to recover. When you pray and you fast, the door opens again. Restoration comes. Newness of life comes. For you to recover, you need to initiate fasting and then
prayer.
How many people fasted the day of our covenant fasting? If you are here, you fast. Raise up your hands. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. They are not up to 40 that fasted. Church of population of almost 300 for covenant fasting. How are you going to recover if you are not a time to pray and a time to fast? How will you recover? Recovery does not just come without pursuing. You need to pursue your recovery through prayer and then fasting. Those who are not been praying and fasting, I pray that may God help you.
Amen.
Some of you cannot fast even 6 to 6. Even though you cannot fast 6 to 6, at least 3, you can still fast on the 3. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I don't think if I remember the day that I did breakfast last. I don't think. I remember day that I did breakfast last. If you must recover, you must become a prayer and a fasting machine. Hallelujah. You must become a prayer and fasting machine. That is the only thing that can make you to recover. Then the last one, the seventh one, you must not be a greedy person. The Bible said when David recovered all those things, he began to share it to the elders and to his friends. You must not be a greedy person. There are people now, what you are suffering now is as a result of your greediness. Many people have missed the opportunity. They have used their hand to close so many doors. Why? Because of what?
Greediness.
You need to kill the spirit of greediness. Anyone that have a greedy heart and a greedy spirit, is difficult for you to recover. You will always lost. You will always miss something. Because anything you see, you want to use a greedy mind to grab it. And at the end, you lose it. Your friend bring business, your friend bring opportunity, somebody call you on phone and say, can you do this for me? And because of your greediness, you know that thing, you can do it with 1,000 ringgit or 500 ringgit, but you say it's 10,000 ringgit. And the person that because of greediness, the person go and consult another person. And the person say, I can do it for you with 1,000 ringgit. You have missed the opportunity. I remember when I get to airport, the trolley is supposed to be free. I'm supposed to pick the trolley and use it to carry my load. Somebody just came from nowhere. He said, this trolley is for payment. How much? 500 naira. I said, okay, can you give me a receipt? He paused. No, we don't issue receipt here. I said, you don't know what you're saying. There are policemen, army surrounded there. They didn't talk. Nobody talk. I said, if this trolley is for payment, there must be a receipt. Slice, it disappeared. And another person came and said, sir, this trolley is free. I will help you to carry the load. Anything that comes to your mind, give to me. And he took it and I bring that either 500 or 200 or something like that. And I give to him and I bless him. You see that one who did not put greediness, he benefit. But the one who put greediness, did he benefit?
No.
He will lose everything. Hallelujah. David shared all the things that have been recovered. He began to distribute it, share to people. He began to give. If God bless you now, will you remember God? Will you remember the church and your pastor? You know, we become like, we only ask God, give, 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 but there will never be a day that you appreciate God. Hallelujah. Greediness. That's what closes many people's door. The door open today, tomorrow the door closes. Why? Because of what? Greediness. You need to kill the spirit of greediness. May we be on our feet as we pray. The message says, pursue to do what? Now, what have you discovered to pursue your life? You need to pursue them through this prayer warfare this morning. What have you discovered in your life that is missing, that is lost? You are going to confront them and recover them back. They need to talk to God. Whatever that is missing in your life, pursue, overtake them through prayer and recover them. Speak to God. What is that thing that is missing in your life? What is that thing that lost in your life? You need to pray. You need to speak to God. You need to speak to God. You need to speak to God. Need to speak to him.
Through this way. Don't put oil inside him. Only make sure he's in prison.
Thank you.
And also those who want to, maybe want to take a seat for this anointing or whatever, you take a seat. It's not compulsory and it's not by force. I learned that there are people who want to sow, maybe because they are believing God for one thing or the other. As I'm going to anoint you, I'm not anointing you because of seed. Let me make it clear to you. This anointing is an anointing that will recover everything that you have lost.
Amen.
It's an anointing that will bring them back.
Amen.
Every connection that you have lost, the anointing will bring them back.
Amen.
All the opportunities that you have missed, this anointing will bring them back to you.
Amen.
And I prophesy as this anointing comes upon your life, this first week, you will begin to experience it.
Yeah.
Give me some. Anointing fall upon me.
Recover
in the name of God. Cover my head to do.
Jesus, all our troubles,
anything that you have lost and missed, in Jesus' name.
Jesus name.